Take that!
Yes, I am in a hurry. Edelgard claims victory after victory. She never stops. 5 years ago, she ascended the throne and swept away the corrupt nobles, my father included. I always thought I would be the one to unseat him. But she did it instead, with all the ease and indifference of someone cracking an egg. She put my father under house arrest. She stripped House Eyre of its power. Rather than accepting a role as her puppet, I left. Now I fight to topple the Empire. The disparity between Edelgard and myself is obvious. She never stops moving forward, single-minded, never wavering. But where does that leave me? Here, flailing about, going nowhere, contributing nothing. But it is. That is the reality. Not once since our days at the Academy have I exceeded Edelgard's abilities. I saw her as a worthy opponent. She did not even see me as a contender. She did not even consider me at all. As the head of the noble House Eyre, I must be able to achieve results. But all my efforts have come to nothing. Results are everything. I have not shown results, so I will be stagnating here forever. I appreciate your kind words, but you are wrong. I know that I have a massive wall to climb, and I must climb it alone. Even so, may I ask a favor? Professor, please keep an eye on my progress. I would appreciate if you were always by my side, bearing witness to my accomplishments.
Country with no king has no f- That's why I made my way here. Professor, don't let me down. Yes, let's. Find me a worthy opponent to battle, and I'll be- One to remember. It was meant to be. To be. It was meant to be.
Edelgard is controlling the Empire. She is putting the pressure on the Kingdom and Alliance. Empire and religion are at open war. It will be difficult for us at first. But corrupt nobles are many. That means the common people will rebel and be joining our side. With you, Professor, the battle tides will turn. I have certainty.
Professor, you won't believe what happened. I figured I couldn't go back to the Empire after Garrick Mach fell, so I started drifting across the Kingdom and Alliance. Then, I just happened to run into our old class, so we came back to the monastery together.
This may seem a bit sudden, but I want to thank you, Professor. That is, for letting me live my life the way I want. I've noticed you've been giving me fewer of those soul-revealing gazes lately. I appreciate you making an effort to not trouble yourself over who I spend my time with. Well, of course. Did you think I wouldn't notice? It's kind of sweet in its own way. Professor, may I tell you a story about when I was younger? I was an orphan, living in the back alleys of Enbar, until one day I was overheard singing. That was when my new life began. I was suddenly a songstress in the Mittelfrank Opera Company. Performers, nobility. I met so many people. But none of them ever really knew me. I was just some young, pretty girl who could sing. A spectacle to be admired. Even though everyone praised my looks and my voice, and they showered me with gifts, I knew one day I'd be old. My looks would fade, my voice would change. I wouldn't sound the same. And I started to wonder, when I did get old, what would I have left? I'd be old, alone, and back on the streets of the capital, right where I'd started. That's sweet of you, even if you are just flirting. I never had much to begin with in life, and I worry that one day I'll be that way again. That's why I keep searching for someone who will love me. Someone unaware of the songstress, who can love a girl that used to be scared and alone on the streets of the capital. I wonder if such a strange person can even exist.
Thank you.
Okay.
Right.
Do you have time for a request?
These days, so many old friends seem to be... It's incredible to... I have a feeling your name will go down in history.
Pardon me.
Greetings, Professor. Nothing to report. You know, it's such a thrill to be able to greet you like this again. I almost died as well in the battle 5 years ago. But I won't allow any enemies to get into this place again. I promise you that. Even if the Death Knight shows up, I'll be sure to... Well, for now, I'll keep training, so I can eventually feel confident that I can stop him.
Got a favor to ask. Pardon me.
I can't believe how long it's been since I left home. Since I was dragged out of the house, I mean. 5 whole years. It's weird to think about. No. But if you'd asked me that 5 years ago, I'd have said the opposite. I have friends here, and I have you. The monastery's become a second home to me. Back then, I never would have dreamed a day like this would come. It's all thanks to you. You've given me a second chance at life. If not for you, I never would have gotten used to leaving my room, let alone the monastery. Maybe the battlefield's just dulled my senses. I'm much better with strangers and new places now, though. I don't panic nearly as much as before. A new place? That sounds like a tough assignment. Where did this... You're teasing me, aren't you? Please don't joke around like that anymore. It's torture for me. You're still not taking me seriously. I mean it. Promise me you won't do that again. Franz... Good. I'll hold you to that. You're absolutely not allowed to send me out anywhere on my own. You would need to come with me. If you're with me, I can go anywhere in the world. Why can't you get what I'm saying? I thought we were finally getting close. I guess I'm not good enough for that, though, am I? I'll let you have this one, but you better be ready for next time.
Thank you.
I need a favor.
Hey, I could use a hand.
You walk. I will be with you every anything you ask of me. I shall see it through. You saved my life.
Professor?
During his search for her grace, the Archbishop, Setteth has visited churches all across the land. It served to demonstrate to the devout across Fodlan that the Church of Seros is still going. As a result, the faithful are not currently in a state.
A mercenary than a knight these days. I work to get paid. I never was too attached to Fodlan, but I might change my mind if you're around.
Hello.
In Lady Rhea's absence, I will follow you. Know that wherever you might lead us, I'll continue searching for Lady Rhea. Good, because I will not budge on that point.
From the Empire. But I have no intention of ever. This war the Emperor instigated has caused nothing but trouble. I want this war to end. And that's why.
Professor, please do not be concerned. I just did too much overworking and lost my strength. Yes, I have no problems. Accept my apology for giving you worry. I have sorrow. I am sorry to be fainting at a time like this. Even though I was not asking for your care and attention, you gave it willingly. I am thinking that is incorrect. Will you have a listen to me? There is something that I must be saying. I am thinking you already have knowledge of why I came to Fodlan. Not for studying, but as a hostage for the Empire. So that Bridget would not be rebelling anymore. It feels like a knife against my throat. That I am making my grandfather obey the Empire. If I were running away from the Empire, then Bridget would be defeated. I am not having any options. To be living, I must be fighting to win. For Bridget to be living, the Empire needs to be crushed. So I must be crushing the Empire. That is what my people are wanting from me. And what my grandfather, the King of Bridget, is wanting. Truth. I wonder what I should be doing. I want to be granting the wants of my tribe, so their wants are my own, correct? What I really want. I have understanding. Wait, no, I actually do not have understanding. Yet. What I am understanding is that there is something I am not understanding. When I know what my true want is, I give you my promise that I will be telling you first.
Oh.
Well. No.
Huh? The town I'd been living in came under attack. My parents were both caught up in the... I've got no home to go back to anymore.
Need something? See you again soon.
It seems that in the last 5 years, the monks here have left this place for the time. However, once they learn of our return, I hope the monastery can return.
With the return of its knights, Garrick Mach is finally coming back to life. The Church of Saros will follow you from now on, but please do not abandon the search for Lady Rhea. Thank you. I have something to ask of you.
My professor, at your age, I'd expect your whole demeanor to have changed greatly over... Though, I suppose I haven't changed either, right? Thank you for noticing, by the... Ah, just the two of us, forever young.
This experience is critical.
Thankfully, I am most curious, though. You say you were asleep for 5 whole. Perhaps this is another effect of your crest. I do look forward to investigating you in greater detail. Wonderful news. I am most... Perhaps...
I have lost my dominion. My nobility may seem like nothing more than a... But I will never lose my noble heart. I will stop Edelgard. I have turned my blade against her now. Professor, do you think I chose the wrong path? You are right.
Yeah, I don't know anything about rebuilding, but I can sure do my best to clean. I'm gonna keep Lady Rhea's room spotless, so she can- You gotta find her, Professor.
Professor.
The promise was made 5 years ago, but I must say I'm rather impressed by how many of us managed. Personally, I only showed up because I hope to see you again. I've been with my family in the Empire until recently. I admit to feeling a little guilty betraying Her Majesty, but now that we're all together again, I suppose the...
Oh, good. Thanks.
You've done me a great service.
Thank you.
Well done. You have my thanks.
Professor? You didn't hear that just now, did you? Right! You didn't? Well...
I figured it then. Hey, Professor! I figured it then.
Professor, it's incredible. I have a feeling.
The promise was made first.
Now that we're all. I'll use this power for the greater good.
Edelgard Empire, but corrupt with you.
There's still more to...
Professor?
No matter anything you ask...
Thank you.
am... I am...
I'll get... That...
Thank you.
Tell me something. Yeah, great answer.
Professor.
Nothing is impossible for us.
Let's try our best.
Amazing, no?
I'm just not there yet.
Sing so loud that my voice is gonna
May my song reach the goddess in the
word.
I'm awake. I'll cut through.
More fighting.
What's my strategy?
I do this for all of us.
Keep it up.
I will prevail.
Put me in there.
Ready for anything.
There's no stopping me.
I suppose. Oh, lovely. Amazing!
That's fast.
No use.
Ha!
Maybe...
I could learn from that.
Good assist. Thank you.
Well done.
Ready for anything. I'll take all the strength I can. What's my strategy?
I will prevail. No use! I do this for all of us.
I'll follow your example. I'm awake.
I'll cut through.
There's no stopping me.
More fighting.
Too easy. Thank you.
strength. Nice form.
Predictable. There is still...
Why, thank you.
Sorry.
Back to the fray.
I am all-
Thanks for helping.
I fight.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Strength.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Oh. It's... How?
Teacher.
We're on a roll!
Aha! I've learned a thing or two from battle.
Thank you so much.
I'll cut through.
What's my strategy?
Strength.
Ready for anything.
I do this for all of us. I will prevail.
Put me in there.
More fighting.
I'm awake.
Onward.
There's no stopping me.
That helps.
Just let...
I can feel it in my bow.
I can learn from that.
all this power.
I think I'm improving.
Bye. Sorry.
Must pull through.
Thank you.
Nice form.
Much needed.
I'll cut through.
What's my strategy?
I will prevail.
Ready for anything.
Put me in there.
I'm awake.
I do this for all of us. Onward!
More fighting.
There's no stopping me.
This level...
Yeah!
Pointless.
Thanks for helping.
Of you.
Nice form. This'll help.
Can't let it.
I'm grateful.
Ah! I owe you one.
It is done.
Now is the time to master.
Age is but a number. Thanks. I'm glad I asked you.
Easy.
Huh? Caspar? Whatever is he doing here? Oh no. Is he looking for a fight with someone taller than him? The poor boy won't give up.
This is it! Today's my day! Caspar's day! Come get some!
Yes, Caspar, just like that! Just as we practiced! Yes, dodge! Yes! Perfect! Right there! He's open! Punch him right in the... Yes! Caspar, you did it!
And that's how it's done! Woo! And then I got him! Bam! Right in the solar plexus! Oh, I really wish you could've... Hey! Are you even listening? This is when it starts getting real good!
I'm listening. I am sad to say, however, that the tale is slightly less thrilling the fourth time through.
You should be more excited! We finally won!
We?
Yeah, I couldn't have done it without your advice. You're a strategic genius, Linhart.
Nonsense. Your strength carried the day. I just rambled on. You're the one who did the actual work. What's really amazing is how you wouldn't give up.
Whoa, I've never heard you compliment me before. Yeah, I don't think I like it. Seriously, though, I couldn't have done it without you. Like you said, I wouldn't give up on fighting, and I'm not gonna give up on this either.
I should have expected that, I suppose. That's just the kind of guy you are, after all. I guess this friendship is something that we can never escape from. Ever.
Are you saying you want to escape from our friendship?
Not at all. Even if I did, our fates would not be so easily untangled.
Ha! You got that right! No one can break this bond. Even if we argue and butt heads sometimes, we'll never have to fight it out. And that's a promise.
Understood. I don't desire to fight anyone anyway. This war is the last time I'll set foot on a battlefield.
Well, that makes sense.
Let's you and I come out the other side of this war alive and well, okay? That is a promise worth making.
Definitely. And let's win this thing while we're at it.
Ah, Dorothea. I am surprised to find you here. I did not think you were all that religious.
There's a lot you don't know, Ferdy. But you're right. I'd hardly call myself devout. After all, it was thanks to the goddess and her noble regime that I suffered so much as a child.
You must be quite brave to speak so coarsely in this hallowed place. But what do you mean about suffering as a child?
Do I really have to tell you? Oh, forget it. I'm sure you already know that I'm an orphan. I grew up in the alleys of Enbar, begging for coins, eating scraps, drinking from drains.
I see. I remember seeing street children around the city.
I could have died. Then the right person overheard me singing. And suddenly I was in the opera. I was a songstress. And my goodness, did the nobles like me. The people who used to spit on me and call me an urchin, they praised my voice and my beauty. A nobleman who once kicked me gave me the most gorgeous shoes. I almost asked if it was a joke.
So that is why you despise the nobility. But why do you think I am the same as them? Do you really believe that is the kind of man I am? You think I would ever treat people differently based on appearances? There is nothing noble about that.
Oh, really? You're something different? That's not how I remember things. It was the very day that I was discovered. I was in high spirits. Nothing was wrong in the world. I secretly bathed in one of the town's fountains, hoping to wash off some of the dirt from the streets. I sang the same song the opera composer overheard earlier that day. And that's when you appeared.
Me? No, it could not have been.
Don't play dumb. You glared at me, the same look I'd gotten from every other noble, then you ran off. When we met at the academy, you were a different person. All smiles and friendly words. You were like a bee, Ferdinand. A bee attracted to a flower in full bloom.
So it was you then, singing that song. Dorothea, please listen. This is a misunderstanding. When I saw you, I could not take my eyes off you. I was hypnotized. Your beautiful voice, your elegant face, droplets of water on your skin that glittered in the sun. I thought you were a water nymph.
Stop it, don't lie to me.
No, it is true. I was only a child. The vision overwhelmed me. That is why I ran. I plucked up the courage to return, but no one was there. I thought perhaps it was a dream.
Maybe I can believe you. I've wanted to ever since the day you made me those treats. I thought then that maybe you weren't like the others, but there's a lot I have to let go of, Ferdy.
Of course. I am glad we had this conversation. You know, I do not mind life as a simple drone, circling a queen. It actually sounds quite...
Don't drones keep the queen safe from other bugs?
Ferdinand.
Huh? Ah, Petra. Is that...
No, I am not needing help. I was just thinking...
Lonely? In wartime? Hardly. I am too big... But once we have survived, what will you do with yourself, Petra? As an Imperial hostage, you would be freed if the Empire were...
Yes. My plan is to be returned, but if Bridget and Fodlan can be friendly, I will be able to have... Maybe it is even possible for me to be living in...
Live in Fodlan? Do you...
I do have the hope of returning one day. But Fodlan... I came to Fodlan 9 years ago. My family is living in Bridget. But in Fodlan, I have new family and new friends.
New family? I am glad to hear you feel that way about us, Petra. In that case, we will have to make sure that none of us die. We do not want to lose anyone in the family.
Yes, we will be winning, and you will not be dying.
Ha! Do not worry. I do not intend to die. I have some things to do when the war is over.
Things?
Yes. You and I can be the link between Fodlan and Bridget.
Oh.
Okay, I have to confess. I fibbed a little. About not being lonely. When this war ends, I will be quite lonely indeed. If you go back to Bridget.
Is that a truth?
I have just made a decision. I will work as an ambassador, whether you are in Bridget or Fodlan. Then both places can move forward together. We ought to join forces and make that a reality.
You have my gratitude, Ferdinand. I have loneliness, just like you. But your words gave me, please do what you are saying, and be a bridge for Fodlan and Bridget.
You can count on me. We will keep at it, and one day...
Yes, one day... Oh no, it's... If I run, he'll chase me. Maybe...
Ahem.
Unless I'm offending you just by standing...
No, here. I believe...
Huh? Oh, yeah, that's my satchel. Wait...
Stop asking questions and just...
No!
Why are you acting like...
Acting? Does this terror on my face look fake to you?
You're being difficult. Come on.
I can't. Your icy glare has frozen me. Come...
Shut up. Just...
No!
What? Who's going to...
Sword! He's got a sword!
My sword! How did you...
I can't do this anymore!
What an odd girl. But she's certainly caught my attention. I've never seen that technique. Oh, I still have to give this back.
Wow, you look... I wonder what he's writing.
That phrase doesn't quite work, does it?
Too uncertain for a diary.
No, that's bound to introduce misunderstanding.
It must be really important if he's putting that...
But I mustn't overcomplicate things either.
Parting? It's a farewell letter?
Sedith can be a little scary sometimes, but I hope he shouldn't make such rash decisions. If he's an...
Come now. Do you...
You...
If you don't wish to be heard talking to yourself, then you should not... I'm sorry to hear that you find me in...
I won't disturb you,
Wait, Bernadetta.
Ah, typical behavior for the girl. Most concerning. Can she really...
Oh, Petra, are you...
Yes. I am investigating useful fighting techniques.
You're always trying to become a better fighter. Personally, I'm sick.
You are feeling sick about battle?
Oh, sooner the better. I don't even remember the last time I washed my hair.
Yes, it is hard to be braiding your hair when it is damaged from lack of care.
Speaking of, you know, I don't think I've seen many braids like yours, Petra. I assume it's a hairstyle from Bridget? May I?
You may. This style of braiding has been passing, has been passed down.
How very elaborate. That must take a long time to-
Your words are delighting me. Braiding it does take up a great amount of time every day.
Every day? Now I suppose you couldn't sleep with your hair like that. When there's time, do you think you could teach me? It would be fun to match you every now and once I learn how, I can help you with your hair.
I am really liking that idea. It would give me great happiness to have our hair match.
I'd like it too.
Dorothea, before I had confusion. I thought you were being overly familiar, but then I gained understanding. Now I am knowing that is how you show your kindness, and I have much gratitude. It is impossible to be imagining life without you.
Petra, what a lovely thing to say.
If you will be crying, you can have my... my shoulder.
Oh, I was just playing around. But if I ever do need a good cry, I do hope you'll...
My shoulder will always be a...
Oh, yeah? So I don't even need to make a
A reservation?
Oh, I just meant... You know what? What matters is that I enjoy spending time with you.
If that is the truth, then will you be coming to Bridget with me?
Huh?
When this war is finished, I am wishing for you to be seeing my home...
I'd love to, Petra. As soon as the fighting is done, I'd like nothing more than to see Bridget with you.
May I help you, sir?
Finally noticed me, I see. Good to see that you are so dedicated to your training.
Do you have need of my...
No, this is not a military matter. I would like to discuss the distance you seem to be keeping from the other.
Distance?
I have noticed that you like to keep others at arm's length. And in most cases...
keeping a close... They don't share my values.
Is that why you train alone? Because you're...
You seem dis... I suppose you're going to tell me, to defeat your enemies you must have...
That's not exactly how I would phrase it. But having good relationships with your allies is... I am sure you realize that it is easier to bond with people when you interact. There are limits to what one person can do alone. Great things can...
You sound like my father. You're saying it's in my own interest...
To put it simply, yes. As much as you possibly can. Because I know what it is like to not have many people to call friend.
I wouldn't have guessed that. There are so many...
I am talking about friends. People to speak with on e- You have many friends here. You should take-
I'll consider your advice, but I'm not usually one to change my-
to be young.
Hello, Professor Manuela. I wish you to know that I have heard ever so much about your
What singing?
Why, you are wonderful. Why, I have even overheard people saying your voice is akin to the...
It makes me happy to hear.
Oh, the students are always speaking of it. I may be the only person in all of the academy who's... So, I was wondering, Manuela...
Your request is touching, but I can't perform on such short notice. My voice isn't... However, the stories are true. I was once the leader of the Mittelfranc troupe, but that was a...
Mittelfranc?
what do those... You've never heard of the Mittelfranc troupe? Before the war, it was the single most popular opera company in the Imperial capital. I used to sing...
Oh, wow! In all of Enbar? They must not have been around when I was little.
You used to live in Enbar?
Indeed. Although, I was quite a bit younger at the time. It is where I was born, as a matter...
Oh, well, you must have...
Yes, that could be. And what precisely is the function of an opera troupe?
You don't know what an opera troupe is? Well, it's a group of performers, like myself, who act out stories on stage in front of a big audience.
Oh, I understand now. I certainly have experience in the... There is often singing as a part of story time for the children at the monastery.
That is darling, Flame. But I'm not sure it's quite the same thing as an operas are performed in grand theaters with orchestral accompaniment. Everyone attending wears their finest. It is a...
Theaters, they're called? You mean to say that there are buildings exclusively...
You've never even... You're an intelligent girl, Flame, and the world is full of wonders. You have...